Your source for Falcon, Fairlane, Full Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck, Cougar. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
All right, because we're putting a dash pad in a car that doesn't have one from the factory, we have a problem. We have no way to know where the studs on the backside of the dash pad go on the dash panel. We know where the holes are on the dash panel because of what we received from one of our friends on Facebook, but we don't know where to put the holes as far as the dash pad itself is concerned. So what we have to do is we have to make a template. We use some poster board, tie them together with some tape, and then go in and lay that down. We centerline the studs on the piece of paper. That way we know what center is. Now, there is some ish movement because of the holes we're going to show you in just a few minutes, but for right now, this gives us a centerline point so that we know exactly what centerline, quote unquote, should be on the dash pad. All right, so we're taking and putting the dash pad on our 63.5 Galaxy 500 Fastback today. It could be an in theory, though, because what we may end up getting done is the holes bored in the dash, making sure everything kind of fits, and then having to go out and get a bunch of parts that we didn't know we needed. For instance, like the defroster duct bezels that go on top of the dash pad. We're also having a real problem right now with the center speaker grille on this car because it is held in with wing nuts. I'm not real sure that that's a factory thing, but it's a pain because wing nuts, when the bolts get rusty, are a real handful to get out. So that is what I'm working on right now. It's a lot of fun. One of these is not so bad and the other one's really bad. All right, so this thing right here with this clip took about 20 minutes to get out just simply because of that little wing nut right there. Wing nuts suck. If the screw is rusty and the screw on one side of this is rusty and the other side is fairly clean, so I'm gonna get the other side out now. I'm not gonna show you that because you really can't see it anyway, but that speaker grill has got to come out whenever you're doing this. So I'm gonna go to the other side and get the other one out. All right, I've got a little bit of super clean on here, and basically what I'm trying to do is to get this dash pad cleaned down a little bit so I can throw some tape on it to do my mark out. And it's just, I'm not really gonna clean this dash panel yet, other than a light clean to keep from getting schmutz all over the dash pad itself. But I wanna basically put a piece of tape across here so that I can get my line points where I need them from the markup that we got from one of our friends on the Galaxy forum on Facebook. And I will say this right now, anymore, Facebook is a really good place to go to get information if you're doing something crazy like we're doing here, where we're going to be putting a dash pad in a car that doesn't have one. So I'm going to show you some tips and tricks on what to do in order to get the dash pad to fit if you're not working with a factory dash. If you're working with a factory dash, that dash pad from the guys at Auto Crafters will pop right in here just absolutely okay. All right, so tape it down. That's getting out to go get the tape that sucks. My back. All right. Now, according to what Aaron Locke sent us in photographs, it looks like all of the holes along here are 1 inch off of the top of this trim right here. And so we're basically pulling a line using a tape measure just like the one he used. This is basically one that you could get from box stores or whatever for fabric measurement. A lot of tailors will use these. So I am marked off now with that. Anytime you get something from somebody like that, try to mimic what they do whenever they're showing you what they're working with, because that will make all the difference in the world with you putting all this stuff back together. So I'm going to go ahead now and get my piece of cardboard and run a line all the way over to here, hopefully keeping it fairly level, because I'm thinking that 1 inch over here is going to be a little squirrely because of this trim piece. And there is one final bolt that goes in over here. Oh, this is one of those stupid double ends that they don't have a cap for. Well, a cap holder. Ooh. Okay, I've got my piece of paper taped up here. Now, what this is, where all the studs are at on the dash pad across the bottom line of it. And I've also marked my tape, as I said before, for the distance from the trim piece here up onto the dash panel for the bolt holes. Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go in now and I'm going to mark a line where all of the center lines are on these all the way across, and then we should be good to go. And then what I'll start doing is I've got to go in then is mark the distance, the height for the elongated holes. All right, these holes on these factory dashes are 1/4 inch tall by 1 inch wide. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and start marking up all of these for position. Because the, he was right there. All right, now I've already marked this one for center line because this was basically the best shot I had from Aaron Locke of where the holes are on this side of the dash panel. I've got a lot of information for the last hole on the other side of the instrument cluster, but this one is the closest I could get. So these will all kind of be an ish as far as I can tell. So I'm going to go ahead and get this all pulled down, my little marker here, and take that out of the way and mark my center lines vertically, and probably going to start cutting pretty soon on my dash panel that I only have one of. Now the distance to the edge of the panel where the instrument cluster goes and the center of the hole here is about 1 1/8 inch. All right, so now we're fixing to work on the most complicated of all of these, and that's the one on the outside edge right here at the A-pillar. It is 13/16 inches off of the top of the trim to the bottom of the hole, and it's 3/8 inch over from the break point where the instrument cluster inserts inside of the dash panel. So we're gonna have to make our hole that way, and plus it's on a curve. So it's got a real problem here with trying to make that the way it needs to be. And what I'm gonna talk to you about in just a second is how I'm gonna overcome those problems if I have to go in and start enlarging these holes, which I have a feeling I might need to do. Thank you. All right, so we've got everything done. Now, the first thing I did after I cut all my holes is I went after it with a reamer like this. When you get these at most of your like places like Harbor Freight and things like that, any tool house will sell these. And I tell you, doing this kind of stuff, it's a real boon. It just keeps you from having anything that will grab the nuts and washers on the backside of the dash pad, which I'm going to talk about that in just a second. What we did is we went in and just made our cuts after we got everything measured out. Remember, it's always measure twice, cut once. In our case, we just went with it. Because I have a feeling that no matter what I did with my measure, I'm probably going to have to start opening these holes up just a little bit. All right, now I'm done with this, but I'm going to talk about these. Now, this is the nut, the 832 nut that comes with the kit. But these washers we went down and bought at the Home Improvement Center, these are stainless washers, just like the nuts are stainless. And the washers are actually pretty good for if you have that issue that we're talking about where you need to go and open the holes up on a dash panel that doesn't have the factory holes. This dash pad is going to bolt right in if you have a factory dash that is a dash pad dash. It's a lot of words. But if you don't and you're doing what we're doing, you are probably going to have to muck around with your hole positions just a little bit. And the reason I say that is this is all ish kind of stuff with this setup. So when you're looking at this, you want to make sure that you pick up some of those washers that are a little bit bigger so when you're tightening the dash pad up, if you do need to make larger holes, you can. Now for the moment of truth, I'm going to go in and actually put the dash pad in the car and see if it actually aligns up with the holes here. If it doesn't, I may have an issue where I'm going to have to go into the Dremel tool and start opening the holes up just a little bit more. Oh, gotta love Murphy. I don't want to get my camera gear wet. We've got a tent up, but it's really not going to be enough because we kind of have to have the cameras outside of the tent. Tent's mostly there to keep the light off the car. Sometimes. All right, so we got our initial fit. We just threw this up in there. Basically, all we did was roll the dash pad into the holes and then lay it up on top. This is not my final fit. I am just test fitting to see where I have issues. So far, as I can tell, I drilled the holes in the right spot on these, and I'm a little off on this end down here by the door. So I'm going to need to go in and actually work those holes a little bit and pick that up some. Right now, this end is also sitting kicked up because the holes aren't in the right spot. So I get the holes where they need to be, and then I could go in and, if I wanted to, finish this side up and that side up. I will say that we're not going to completely install this dash pad all the way. I'm going to go over a couple of little things that you have to deal with when doing a dash pad here in just a second. The reason that this has slotted holes in the dash panel is so that you can move this dash pad back and forth a little bit, even in the factory situations, because these dash pads are not really located in any other way. So what you'd want to do, let me get up in here. What you're going to want to do is to make sure whenever you're setting this, that the top part of this is sitting in the right location. In other words, you want this so that it's up against the wall on either side, and you should have a good fit from that. And then these pieces back here, this will all be tied down with the trim piece that goes in there. And again, because of how the guys at Rhino Fabricators put these things together, it will be a nice clean fit because these holes in the dash pad that you see right here, these holes are actually in the right spot all the way down the line on here. So I could put the trim back in, but I'm a little bit worried about damaging the dash pad in the process, and we don't have these plates for this as well. But I am going to tie it in a little bit so that we can show you what we've got after I fix my problem that I've created down this end of the dash pad. Getting the Dremel out. All right, this is our second trial fit because, like I said, we're not going to be putting this thing in permanently, because we have other fish to fry on this dash panel. So try to get it as close as you can, and then you have to roll it up into place. There we go. Now you see I just moved it over a little bit to try to get the center up on here. That's good up there. And tree, see if I've got enough. Yeah. All Oh yeah. Looking good. Now, if I had everything set, if I had my vents and all, I could actually get this thing to lay in just exactly the way I wanted to, using the vents to hold everything in place, which is what Ford would have done as well. I'm not going to put the fasteners all in. There's no point in doing that because I'm going to pull the dash pad back out. But I have to say, it's very exciting because we've got the headliner done. We've got a brand new dash pad, and it looks really good in position. Now, there's a couple little things I wanted to talk about. They give you a little bit of overage on either side of this in vinyl so that you can get it to wrap around, and you won't see any of the dash panel. You'll only see pad on either ends. There's plenty of what I would call slevage or slevit, slex. Anyway, somebody told me I said it wrong the other day. Okay, that stuff that's left over on the end of the dash pad out there, there's actually plenty of the stuff, extra stuff here. If I were to put the trim piece back in, I would be real happy with the way this thing lays. You would need to have the vents, obviously, the vent covers on here for that to be finalized as well. And then your radio bezel would hold everything in place. Probably what I would do in final, and what I will do in final, is I will go in and use maybe a little bit of trim adhesive or weather strip adhesive along the back edge of this piece here where the radio sits, and on the back side of the dash pad itself, to get that to lay in a little bit better, a little bit tighter up at the top. But I think with the radio bezel in place and with that in there, you probably wouldn't even need that. It's a nice looking piece, folks. Once everything got tightened up and all, this would all straighten out and sit just the way it's supposed to. I'm telling you, this is a nice one, and it went in really easy compared to the Falcon one I did years and years ago. It was really something I was worried about. All right, so you may be wondering, what am I going to do with my radio bezel? Because we've said that that's not going to work with a padded dash. And what I would do is I would go in and I would put some Play-Doh that's too tall on these studs here and in the back here, set the radio bezel in after I've gone in and weather strip adhesed the dash pad itself with the other trim pieces in, and then start working this to make sure it's going to sit level in the dash pad. And what you do is you just set it in place and then you push it down to where it's level across the front, pull it back out and take a measure off of the Play-Doh on it so you know what you've got to make your stands with. And that can be made with metal, they can be made with plastic, whatever. My preference would be like a plastic tube of some kind, because it's not going to make a lot of noise and squeak when it's in the dash panel like a metal piece would do. What I would like for you to do is leave a comment in the section below. Tell me what you've run into if you've done one of these dash pads on your Galaxy. Also, when you do that, be sure to give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down. That's all entirely up to you. And subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. Get other people to subscribe. Get your grandmother to subscribe. Get your, I don't know, somebody that you don't even like. Get them to subscribe, because we're going for 100,000 subscribers by Christmas. That's my goal for this year, is I want to get 100,000 subscribers, because that's what I want for Christmas. 100,000 subscribers so I can get that stupid plaque from the guys at YouTube. I know, small minds, blah, blah, blah. But I really want that plaque. I want it pretty bad. I really want to get this thing done, because this just gets me all excited. New steering wheel, get the dash panel redone, maybe a set of Dakota Digital gauges in it if somebody wants to see those done. Build the 390, do the 4-speed, get with Bill Healy and get a new 4-speed shifter that doesn't do this. Anyway, folks, we'll see you on down the road. It really needs to be better. I don't even think there's a gear here anymore.
Yeah. Don't worry about it, it's only next.
Oh.
Yeah, camera 1 is live. I'll give it the link, bottom set, and action.
Whee!